Hello, everyone, and welcome back to our learning series about how to use Figma as someone who is not a designer by trade. As a reminder, we are working on learning as product builders how to create lightweight wireframes, prototypes in Figma design well enough that we can visually communicate with our stakeholders and get their buy-in. We just kicked off yesterday with our intros, and we're here on day two, ready to learn all about file creation. And luckily, we have our wonderful teacher, Lauren, joining us. Lauren, thanks for being here again today.
You bet.
You ready? Should we create some files?
Yes. Let us get kicked off. Okay. So I'm going to bring us just out into the Figma UI over here, and we can talk about where you're going to be starting. Because as somebody who's just getting started in Figma, especially as somebody who's just become an editor in Figma, it's going to look a little bit blank here. So I want to make it a little more organized and just feeling like you know where a little bit more where things are. Starting off in our drafts, this is where a lot of folks will go to create personal projects. I have in my other account, I have just a million untitleds because this is where I go to test out a color or something like that. But as you start to work with people and start to collaborate, you really want to work in your teams. So I'm going to show you how to move things over. First of all, there's nothing here right now. And this is very intimidating. Like, where do I even go? So my suggestion is to start, if this is what you're seeing, a very kind of like blank UI, start off in your workspaces. And I'll start off here by saying this is, we're on the enterprise plan, so we have workspaces. If you are on a org or a pro plan, you probably start off with teams. Something should be here though. So we're gonna start off over here with our workspaces. Okay. Here we can see all the different workspaces that exist. And I know that we are part of the advocates workspace. So I'm gonna go into here. And if you're not sure what workspace you're part of, because there might be a ton of them, what then I would suggest is check some teams to see if you've been added to any teams. So here we can see I've been added to these two teams. So let me pop into Lauren and Katie's learning live stream. I'm in this team.
So Lauren, when I click in on those, does that just mean I have access to them if I'm seeing them here?
Yeah, so you should be, either, I think these ones are my team, so I've been added to these teams. In my workspaces though, if I wanted to look where other teams are, so let's pop into our advocates and architects here. There's a bunch of different teams. Yeah. I'm not added to these, but I can see, like I can ask to, actually this one, I'm on the demo assets one, I can leave that one. This one, I can pop into this. And over here now on our right-hand side, we'll see join team. If I'm not part of it, I'll have the option to join it. There are some secret teams where you won't be able to see them, or there are some closed teams. So it might have, let's see, I think these are all open, but if it was a closed team, I think it would have a lock over here. And it would say, like how this says leave, it would say request to join. So some you do have to request to join, and that'll just go to the admins and then they can let you into that team.
Is it safe to assume that if I'm poking around like this, I'm not messing anything up just by viewing things?
Nope. Yeah, you can't, you're not going to mess anything up. Yep. You can just look around. If there's things that you're not supposed to be in, it will probably be a locked team or a secret team. So anything that's open, I think it's okay to look around and see which teams you want to join in here. So here we go. Here's a private team. This one, I can't get in. I have to ask to join. So I'd have to put a message here of like, why do you want to join this team versus these two? This one, I'm part of this team. I can tell because I can leave it.
Yeah.
And this one, I'm not part of this team, but it's an open team. So I can still go into it and see what's in there. And that's really helpful. It's, I think, especially if you're part of a company and you're not working on something that's like secret or confidential or anything, it can be really helpful to make these open teams so that people can collaborate, because the whole nature of Figma is collaboration here.
Absolutely. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. Let's pop back to our advocates team and then go into our Lauren and Katie learning team. And at this point, I know this is where I'm going to be a lot. This is the Lauren and Katie learning live stream. This is where we're going to keep all of our files. I want to be able to more easily access this. So I'm going to go ahead and hover over this. And when I hover over, I can get a star. And now you see this popped up right over here. And I can add as many things as I want in this starred. I can also add, like, you can customize your sidebar however you want it to be. And let me give you an example here. If I pop back into my other account over here. So if I'm in my
untitled, you were talking.
Yep. So these are all my untitled. A lot of times it might even be by accident or something that I'm opening one, or just like to test out like a shape or a color or something. I got all my untitled. But you can see here, I've organized all sorts of things, that some advocate stuff, starred things that I just want to be able to easily access, all my stuff down here. And how we can do that, if we pop back into our other account over here, is when I'm hovered over starred up here, I can do a new section. So say this is, let's see, collaboration with Katie. And everything that I'm doing under collaboration with Katie, I can put right up there. So this can be all in here, and I moved that over there. And we can star teams, we can star projects, and we can star files. So I'm back into my workspaces now here, going back into advocates. If we were to create a file in here, so let's go into here, we'll create our first new design file.
And we're doing it.
We're doing it live. And I'm going to double click on this to name my file. So we're gonna call this lesson one. And now from inside of my file, a lot of times people will just send you a file, like as a PM or a developer or whoever, a designer might just send you a file. You might not be finding it from your way in Figma. So from inside the file, I clicked on this arrow right here, and I can say either I can move it to a project if I want to put it in a specific project, but it's already in the project that I started in. And this might be if you started something in drafts or you needed to move it around, that would be when you want to move to a project. But from here, I can add it to my sidebar. So I can see both the sections that I've started here, starred or collaboration with Katie. And when I add this one to my sidebar now, and I pop back over here, there's our lesson one. So I can easily access this. And the sidebar is customizable by person. It's not, this doesn't mean what I create here is gonna be what's on your screen. It's totally customizable. So you can create a whole different sidebar here. And I think that's in certain tiers too. So just check on what tier of Figma you're in to see the customization there. But yeah, you can customize it to whatever you want it to be. But super helpful just to know that you can star files, because otherwise it's tricky to figure out where everything lives.
And it's great to be able to see how to do that from the file browser here or from the file itself. Mm-hmm. And also helpful to know that you can favorite teams, projects, or files, whatever you need to access often, it seems. And I love that pro tip of setting up those different sections within your sidebar. That is going to be a huge time saver, because I often struggle to find the things I need. So, but this is already, I'm loving this. The last thing that we wanted to, I wanted to just ask about is the desktop app versus the using it from the browser. Can you talk a little bit about
that? Totally. Yeah. So the desktop app and the browser, I find that a lot of PMs and developers, I think because they're so used to being just in tabs on the internet, they are more likely to use the browser, but it's also totally dependent on preference. With designers, I feel like it's totally split half and half. I much prefer the desktop app. I think just because I know that any tabs that I'm in are all gonna be Figma, versus if I'm in the browser, I might have a calendar tab, then a Figma tab, then a something else tab, which like for a PM, that could be really helpful to be able to switch between like your project brief and Figma. So it's totally dependent, but the UI of both of them should be very similar. You won't find too much of a discrepancy between it. It's totally really a matter of preference as far as whether you're using the browser or the desktop. Are you a browser or a desktop person?
I hate to say both. Yeah. I prefer to use the desktop, but when someone sends me a link or something, it often opens in the browser, and then I like just find myself using the browser.
Yep, totally, yeah. There's no, they're totally, it's always annoying to say, what's the answer? There's no right or wrong, but there really is no right or wrong answer here. Like everybody,
always for all of these things, I feel like there's a designer answer and then there's like my way of doing it. I always feel like I'm doing it the wrong way.
No, truly, even like among designers, if you were to poll our team, I can almost guarantee you it's going to be half and half. I know certain people that only use browser, and every time I see it, I'm like, what are you doing there? But then they're like, what are you doing here? Like it's 100%. There's no wrong answer, because you can do the exact same things basically.
Awesome. That's great to know.
Yeah.
Great. So we learned about organizations. We learned about the workspace team project setup, how to favorite things, how to organize our sidebars. And then you quickly showed how to create that new file. Can you just show us where that is again? So when we create our file for tomorrow, we'll be all ready to go.
Totally. So once you can actually do it one of two ways. So if you want it to be in a very specific project, once I'm in the project over here, I can go to new design file or new Fig Jamboard, either one of these right here. I can also just create a new tab. This is where all of my untitleds come from, because if you create it this way, it's not gonna automatically be put into a project. This is gonna go into your drafts here. So you can see this right now is in my drafts. And this is where the being able to move a project comes in really handy. So if we were to move this one to, what did I call it? Lauren and Katie, livestream files, perfect. I'm gonna move it now. And now, This was my untitled one that I just did. You can do it either way, from the top right over in the right-hand corner, or just creating a new tab, basically, and that'll allow you to search both your recents or create a new one up here.
Love that. And that's in the desktop app specifically.
So yeah, so that's another key.
Being the desktop app.
Yep.
It's really easy to create those.
Files. Exactly. Yep. Yeah. Cool. And then.
Okay, so we got our file ready.
Amazing. One last thing I wanted to call out too, going back to a lot of times designers or anybody will just send you a link or invite you to a file, which we'll go over how to invite people in a different lesson. But I wanted to go over notifications up here. If you do lose that file, like if somebody sent it in a Slack or whatever, and you can't find the Slack or you can't find the message, in anything that you've been invited to will be up in your notifications over here. So this is, I shared a file. This was my other account. I shared a file with myself here, which is why it's Lauren shared with Lauren. But from here, this is where I can access this, or this is like, I was made an editor on here. So all of these notifications are where I can accept or decline or just have access. So now if I accept this one, it's going to pop me right into that file here. So this is our assets that we were creating for this live stream here.
What another huge time saver to just find those things.
Very handy.
Fantastic. If you want to go back to our learning file, we can just quickly recap. Today we talked about file creation and organization, and I've added all our check marks because we covered it all.
Woohoo!
Already. We've talked about how to organize files, how to set up those in workspaces, teams, projects. And we talked about creating your drafts versus those untitled working files that you create versus the existing files that are there, and how to create new files. We talked about favoriting and organizing your sidebar, and lastly, using the desktop app. Mm-hmm. So I think we've done it for today, Lauren. This is great.
Neat. We did it. Awesome.
Thank you so much. I've already learned a ton. I feel like we could close here.
Perfect.
This would be a great learning series, but we will continue on tomorrow. We will dig into, now that we have our blank file, how do we structure it? So join us again tomorrow. And thank you so much again, Lauren.
Amazing. See you tomorrow. All right. See you tomorrow. Bye.